Hello, I'm Mark Parker from Improve Your Course Fishing, and today I'm going to take you through how to make a very, very deadly method mix made from, believe it or not, boilies. Now, of course, these are kind of little round carp baits, you know, I mean, these aren't going to stick to a method feeder, so they're going to need some kind of preparation. So, it's ball based around this, which is the mainline cell. I mean, this is a, it doesn't have to be cell, but these are a sort of very popular bait at the moment and have a lovely sort of creamy sort of coconut kind of smell. So when it, once it goes in the water, it really kind of makes a really sort of nice cloud. So what we say, so obviously we're going to take these, which are freezer baits. So these have been thawed out overnight. So you can see they're kind of, I don't know if you can see that on my finger there, but they're quite kind of soft. You know, they're kind of, you know, they're going to sort of pretty much crush up fairly easy. So what we're going to do, the easy way, we take these, obviously you say they come in kilo batches, so do them in smaller batches if you can, because we're going to put them in a food processor like this. I say if you put the whole kilo in, you'll probably just end up jamming the machine, so it's best to do it in three or four stages. So I say give it a whiz up in that, and then what you say, so bring the bucket in here, we've already got some done, as you can see in there, and then this will make, you say you're looking for that kind of almost like a fine crumb. It's almost like a, I don't know, it's like a coarse crumb, I suppose, almost like couscous, that kind of, anyway, you can see there in the bucket, you know, it's kind of really got gone down almost to like a, you say almost like a ground bait. But if you haven't got a food processor, or if you're like me, your wife won't let you have it because you're going to make a mess of it, you can also use one of these quarter crushers. Now it's a bit more, it's going to take a lot longer, but so you basically you put that in there, so give it a quick little crush round like that, give it a little shake, and then as you say that again makes it kind of, you know, very, very fine. So give that just a bit more of a crush there, so it's really, you're looking for almost like a, as I say, a sort of coarse powder, really. Probably a bit coarser than sort of granulated sugar, but say couscous is probably the ideal sort of consistency. What you can do, so once you give it a good whiz up, you can run it through a ground bait riddle, because then say if you do get any sort of bits that have got stuck in, what you do, you just, they're on the top of the riddle, you can either try and push them through. If they're too big to push through, straight back in the blender, whiz it up again, and say you've got this. So that's basically a couple of kilos. But as you can see, say dry boilies, you see, if we put that together, you know, it's going to form into a ball, but it's very dry. It's not going to stick to a method feeder. And as soon as it hits the water, it's going to burst, and you're going to have an empty method feeder on the bottom. Totally useless. So it needs a binding agent, which is where this comes in. Now, this is called base mix, and this is available from any good tackle shop. And for those that don't know or haven't experienced this kind of stuff, basically boilies are made of powder, eggs, and flavors. That's the kind of the three constituent parts. So this is basically the powder. So if you're going to make your own boilies at home, you would be using a base mix, to which you would follow the recipe on the back, put your eggs in, put your flavors in, and then you'd obviously roll them up and make your own boilies. So that's basically what base mix is. So there's nothing, and this is obviously the cell version of the base mix. So again, we're kind of keeping the two flavors right. So to say to about 2 kilos of the crushed up boilies, we're going to put probably a third to maybe half a bag of this base mix. Now, say this is, because this is to make up boilies, this has got sort of glutens as well as other sort of high fish meals and, you know, predigested all sorts of stuff in there, flavors and other bits and bobs, but it's quite glutinous. So this is going to kind of help with the binding agent, because it's no good having a method mix that if you cast in, by the time the method gets to the bottom, and say you've got an empty feeder, all you're going to have there is just a hook bait, and you're not going to get any bites. As I say, give that a good mix in. You can probably be generous and put a bit more in. As I say, the trouble with this, it's a brilliant method mix, shown to me by Matt Chase, Grant Allbutt, on a recent feature we did with him. I don't think he caught a fish out of Barston Lakes, which is full of F1s and little pasties, as well as some big fish, but I don't think he caught a carp less than 10 pound. I mean, it was just this, how good this stuff is. So I say it's not the cheapest, but it will help you to pick out those larger, more wary fish, where, you know, where the carp boys are fishing for them with boilies, you know, so the fish are used to seeing these little round baits, which they obviously love, but in this kind of consistency, all the goodness of this is kind of has been crushed up, so that the surface area, so that the amount of smell and attraction that's going to come from this is 10, 15 fold, you know, because I say the boilies are good, but they're obviously covered in a, because they've been boiled, they've got a shell, where this is all, you know, this is a powder. It's going to be, the smell from this is going to drive them absolutely wild, and on the day, it did. So we give that a good mix up. Now, from here, that's perfectly fine there, or, let's say with Grant, where he does it, you get, this is called a hook bait enhancement system. Again, you can see it's cell. This is basically a boily glug, a dip. It's a sort of level where you can't overcook this. Unlike a sort of a flavour, concentrated flavour that you make your boilies with, where you only maybe add 3 or 4 mil, very highly concentrated. This is a dip. So when you have your boilies, what it's made for is you've got your sort of pre-made boilies. You'd pour this over, and you would leave those boilies soaking in it for a day, a month, a year, if you want. You know, it's not going to do any harm. So this is, and it's sort of oil based as well. So this is also going to add a bit more attraction. It's going to sort of go up through the layers, because obviously oil rises, but other sort of, you know, and it's going to sort of have attraction of smell at all levels. So we just, so this is an optional extra. You can either just put, you know, a good glug of that in, say, about a third of a bottle. Don't need it, as I say, there's plenty of smell in the cell anyway, but this just kind of gives that extra boost, I suppose. And let's see what we do. We give that a really good mix round, so we get that well and truly through the crumb there. And you see, I mean, it's a pity this isn't in smell-o-vision, because this is beautiful. It kind of smells of almost like, if anyone eats Thai green curries, it's kind of like that sort of creamed coconut bars you get. I mean, you could almost eat this yourself. It absolutely smells wonderful. But there we go, so that's nicely mixed through, you see. But as you can see, it's still fairly dry, because with the base mix, as I said, this is designed to go with eggs, which obviously, you know, makes your boilies. This is the kind of adds the binding agent. But as you can see that with the base mix in, it's become a lot firmer, a lot more, you know, grippy, and that's gonna stick to a feeder much better. But just one stage further, this is basically, like, I suppose now, a method mix ground bait. So like any ground bait, just to make it bind even better, we just add a little bit of water. And so this can be lake water, which is ideal. And then say, again, we just give this a good mix up. And see, so you can see in the bucket there. So even this is made of boilies and base mix and glug. Once you get into the sort of powdered stage, it's basically just a ground bait. It's just a posh ground bait. And so we treat it as such. So we just add the water, just so that those particles get nicely soaked, and so it'll grip to your feeder. Probably needs a, how are we looking there? As you can see, I mean, that's, you know, that's starting to bind really nicely now. Probably just a little bit more water in there. You see, you don't need a lot. So the base mix makes it nice and sticky, and you see you've got the extra glug in there. And we'll just give that, say, a good whiz round. Oh, there we go. So this is the messy part. A bit where you could do with the Blue Peter version of one I prepared earlier. But then that would be no good, because you wouldn't see how we did it. Right, there we go. And that's it. Right, there we go. So we've still got a lovely, fine consistency. Lovely, beautiful. Look at that. I mean, it's a lovely, fine crumb breakdown. That's going to break down beautifully in the bottom once it goes off the feeder. But as you say, into one hand there, give it a squeeze with one hand, and there you go, look, see, it's nicely bind. That's going to grip to a method feeder perfectly now. You could fish that in 10, even 15 feet of water, safe in the knowledge that that's going to break, stick to the feeder. And so what we'll do anyway, so I'll just a little mix here, and we shall just put some into the water down here, and you can see exactly how that'll break up on the bottom. So what I'll do, I'll get rid of that. I'll just bring the water in here, whether you can see that. And see, we just place it in there. It's probably a slightly biggish lump, but as you can see, that's just peeling away ever so slowly. You know, that's going to break down over a sort of period of about 90 seconds, 2 minutes, perfect for the method. And as you can see, whether you can just see in there, all those lovely, so there's sort of cloud, it's forming. This is all the sort of milk and attractions and sort of stuff are coming out of this base mix, all these pre-digested fish meals and stuff that's in the cell. And this is what is driving the fish absolutely mental. You know, you've got this target here of food, as you can see, just breaking down ever so slowly, going to cause a very lovely carpet with your hook bait. It's going to be sitting right on the top there perfectly. But all around is going to be this big halo of kind of creamy smell attraction, which the fish are going to see from a long way off, and it's going to drive them absolutely balmy. As you say, give it a go, it won't let you down. I've been Mark Parker of Improve Your Course Fishing. Give it a go, and thanks for watching.